Welcome everyone to Defender for Cloud in the Field. Thank you all of you that subscribe to the Microsoft Security channel and specifically to our Defender for Cloud in the Field playlist. Make sure to hit the bell to receive notifications. And if you are not a subscriber, please go to the AKA link below and subscribe. Well, today we are going to switch gears a little bit because we're going to talk about a quite recent topic and very hot one, which is a supply chain attack. And for the first time in the show, this security researcher will be presenting some of the findings that he made based on a paper that he wrote, which I'm going to share the link later on. So welcome to the show, Hagai Kestenberg.
Hi, Yuri. Thanks for having me. It's always a pleasure.
Absolutely. Before we start, Hagai, can you give us an overview of what you do at Microsoft and some of the things that you are working on?
Sure. So I'm Hagai. I'm part of the Microsoft Defender for Cloud Research team. And in the last couple of months, I focused on the relationship between service provider and their customers in Azure from the security perspective. And this is what we're mainly going to talk about today.
All right. Good. Well, so let's start with the article, which I'm going to share the AKA link for the article right now. So you can access and read it. Great job on the article, Microsoft Defender for Cloud Capabilities to Counter Identity-Based Supply Chain Attack. But before we dive into this, can you set the stage and make sure that everyone is on the same page when it comes to supply chain attacks?
Sure. So I think the best way to explain supply chain attack is by a simple example. For instance, imagine a popular video editing software used by many media organizations. And one day, a hacker sneaks into the company that makes this software, and they add a hidden code that steals user video and sends them to the hacker. So when the company releases the update, the organization downloads it because it's software they trust. But along with this update, they also get the hidden code that starts stealing their videos. So this is how the attacker managed to affect the target media organization without breaching them. And this simple example tells it all. Supply chain attacks occurs when attackers affecting a target organization by getting access to one of its suppliers or third-party service providers. And there are many kinds of supply chain attacks. The example I gave is a software supply chain attack. But the supply chain attack we are going to talk about today is identity-based supply chain attack that is more cloud-oriented. This kind of attack occurs when organizations that we can call customers from now grant excessive delegated permission to their third-party service providers to their cloud environment. And let me elaborate a little bit more about those service providers. So many organizations opt for third-party service provider to manage their cloud environment due to the advantages of specialized expertise, cost savings, scalability, enhanced security, and mainly the ability to focus on core business objective. And it's a legitimate need, it's not a bad thing. And because the popularity of these solutions, attackers and threat actors have begun to target those service providers and utilize this new type of supply chain attack that is unique to the cloud. So the practice of the identity-based supply chain attack is attackers or threat actors that infiltrate a target organization by gaining access to its service providers and using the delegated access the service provider has to access the target organization environment. And by the way, we have already seen threat actors like Nobelium that target specifically service provider in order to gain access to their downstream customers.
Thanks for the overview. Now, in the article itself, you wrote, and I'm going to quote now, as opposed to a software supply chain, when an attacker gains access to third-party vendor software, like the SolarWinds attack, the type of supply chain attacks we are referring to here doesn't occur from the third-party software that's installed on your environment, but instead it occurs from granting delegated permissions to your cloud environment. Can you please elaborate more on that?
Sure. So while supply chain attacks are not specific to the cloud, the rise of cloud computing has introduced unique consideration and risk to this type of attack. As opposed to software supply chain attack, like the example I just gave, and like the SolarWinds attack, that is the most known example, the identity-based supply chain attack is more cloud-native And as we already said, it occurs from granting excessive delegated permissions to your service provider for your cloud environment. And let me elaborate more about this delegated access. So we talked about the customer need for service provider to help them manage their environment, and we also mentioned the popularity of it. And because of these reasons, Azure came up with several solutions that are designed for granting service provider delegated access to their customer's environment in a secure way. And those solutions are Azure Lighthouse and Microsoft Partner Center. So Azure Lighthouse and Microsoft Partner Center are both platforms that can help service provider to manage their customer in an efficient way. And to get this clearer, let me focus on Azure Lighthouse. So with Azure Lighthouse, service provider can manage all their customers from a centralized interface in an organized and efficient way. And from the customer side, Azure Lighthouse enables customer to maintain control over who has access to their tenant, which resources they can access, and what actions can be taken. So these two platforms are truly amazing and simplify the service provider and customer relationship in Azure. But when attacker gets their hand on a service provider user account, it's also simplified the work for them, for the attackers, because now they have a centralized interface that enables them to access all the service provider customers' environments, and it could be hundreds of customers, and also a centralized interface that tells them what permissions they have on each one of them. So basically, when talking about the differences between the traditional supply chain attack to the identity-based supply chain attack, we are talking about the risk of this excessive delegated permissions that customers give to their service providers and how attackers can use them when getting their hands on a service provider user account.
Now, you talk about the identity-based supply chain attack from this angle, but can you give a sample scenario that describes the attack flow?
Sure. So we talked about many aspects of this attack, but let me give you the whole example of the attack scenario. So the first stage of the identity-based supply chain attack is attackers or threat actors that manage to get a service provider user account. It could be done by a phishing campaign or even buying this account from the dark web. And the next step, you can call this the reconnaissance step, the attackers will check what permissions they have on the service provider customers' environments. To get this clearer, let's say the attackers using the service provider compromised user account are accessing the Lighthouse interface to check what permissions they have, and they see they have the contributor role over 6 different customer subscriptions. So now, the attackers can use the delegated access they have to access the service provider customer subscription and enable further attacks. So to recap it, with a service provider user account, threat actors can utilize this vector to infiltrate multiple organizations as a high permission user. And with a broad set of permission, the attackers can collect data, they can abuse cloud resources, and basically perform any kind of malicious activity on the customer's environment. And I think that this simple example of the attack flow really emphasizes the reason that service providers are highly targeted by threat actors and the need for proper security mechanisms for both the service providers and their customers.
Definitely, it can be quite damaging if this happens. So I'm assuming that you do have some best practice that you recommend to mitigate this type of attack.
Sure. So in order to reduce the risk of identity-based supply chain attack, we recommend following the security best practices for both Partner Center and Azure Lighthouse. They both have great documentation and security content. And by implementing those security mechanisms and following the principle of least privilege, I think that organizations could minimize the risk of getting attacked from third-party vendors and their service providers. So I think both can minimize the attack surface.
While minimizing the attack surface is extremely important, make sure that you elevate your secure posture across the entire solution. We know that Defender for Cloud has also mechanisms to detect this. So what and how Defender for Cloud can help with this type of scenario?
Yeah, so another key point for reducing identity-based supply chain attack is creating visibility for the operations those users with delegated access doing their customers' environments. So by analyzing control plane operation, the resource manager operations, a new capability in Microsoft Defender for Cloud can now identify operations made by those service providers with delegated access to distinguish those actions from member users, regular users, and provide this information in the form of new enrichment for Azure Resource Manager alerts. And this new enrichment that also includes customized remediation steps and description could help security teams to prioritize those alerts triggered with delegated access indication in order to mitigate those attacks in the first steps. So let's go back for a moment for the identity-based supply chain attack we talked about. Let's say the attackers with the service provider compromised user account are using Tor browser when interacting with the customer subscription in order to hide their source IP. So with the new capability, the attacker's activity will now trigger the existing Tor alert with the new delegated access enrichment, as we're just going to see in the demo.
All right, let's go to the demo then.
So I'm now in the Microsoft Defender for Cloud portal. And first, I wanted to show you the existing alert we have in the Defender for Resource Manager. So if a user is interacting with their subscription from Tor browser, this alert should be triggered. But what if this user is your service provider? So till now, our customer didn't have any indication for it in the alert. And now I will switch to the existing alert with the new enrichment, as you can see here. So with the new enrichment that highlight here, our customers now have the indication that basically tells them that not only is it someone interacting with their subscription from Tor, but it's also their service provider. And I think that this enrichment is a true game changer in the field of reducing supply chain attacks and will stop these attacks in the first steps. We can also see that the remediation steps and include customized steps that are different from the original remediation steps that were triggered by a user without a delegated access. And I think with the disinformation and customized take action step we can see here, our customer security teams can now focus on investigating the service provider user account and their actions with all the information they need to efficiently address and mitigate the threat.
This is great. Great addition. Definitely it will add value to the SOC analyst that is investigating this type of attack. Great work there. Hagai, thank you very much for doing the research, writing the paper, and participate in the Defender for Cloud in the Field show. So truly appreciate your work. Thank you.
Thank you. I really appreciate it.
All right, everyone. That's a wrap for today's episode. Make sure to subscribe. One more time with the AK link below. And stay tuned. We have a lot more to come. See you again next time.